This is a demonstration of the Z-spring, or what is called the double cantilever spring, which is an active component of the removable orthodontic appliance, palatally situated. It is used to push one anterior tooth from the lingual or the palatal side to the labial direction. So its main uses is the correction of anterior crossbite of one tooth if we want to make a proclination of an instanding incisor, and correction of rotation of one incisor less than 90 degrees together with a Howley arch by the couple force system. It's never used for the posterior teeth as it will be trapped by the occlusal surface during insertion. The component of it, as we can see here, three equal arms, the first of them, or the active arm, has a non-traumatic end in the shape of a small coil directed away from the gingiva. This arm is always directed to the mesial side of the tooth, unless the tooth is rotated, so it will be directed to the site of rotation. And we have two coils, that is 2 to 3 millimeters in diameter, to increase the flexibility of the wire and decrease its force. The direction of the first coil should be upward, while the second coil is directed downward to keep the spring in one plane, as we can see here. The position of the arms and the coil should be perpendicular to the palatal surface of the tooth that is going to be moved, just like we are seeing here. And the final component is the retentive arm, that is that part which is embedded inside the acrylic, and it is responsible for the retention of the spring inside the acrylic. It has a zigzag shape and parallel to the palatal midline. The gauge of the wire is 0.5 millimeter hard stainless steel wire for the incisors, and it will be 0.6 millimeter if you are going to move the canines. The gauge of the wire is 0.5 millimeter. We are going to start by making the straightening of the wire, holding the wire with the flare and pulling the wire just like this. We will start by making the non-traumatic end, just like this, which is a small coil. As we said, it should be directed medially, unless the tooth is rotated, so it will be directed towards the side of rotation. If it was open, just like this, we can make squeezing by using the angle, the Adam player, sorry. Just like this. The active arm width should be just like the width of the tooth, the mesiodistal width of the tooth, to be moved. So I'm going to point the width of the tooth, the distal side of it. Now we are going to make the first coil. As we said, it should be directed downward, so the wire will be twisted and winded in an upward direction. This is the first coil. Now I am going to point the position of the second coil. Okay. The second coil should be opposite to the direction of the first coil. The first coil was directed downward, so the second coil should be directed in an upward direction. The diameter of the coil is about 2 to 3 millimeters in diameter. And this is the second coil. Okay. Now, the third arm will be ended by a right angle bend, and we will start making the tank, which is a zigzag, just like this, parallel to the palatal midline. The zigzag should be made by using the pyramidal peak of the angle layer, about 5 to 6 millimeters in length, and it ends with an L shape perpendicular on the pellets to elevate the clasp and aid in the retention of the spring inside the acrylic. So this is the Z-spring, this is the non-traumatic end, directed medially as we said, and this is the two coils, the same in diameter, both of them are 2 to 3 millimeter. The first one is directed downward and the second one is upward, and we have three equal arms. The first arm should lie on the cingulum of the tooth, and the whole spring should be perpendicular to the palatal surface of the tooth.